Assalamu alaikum. My name is Shumaila Mehdi and I am lecturer here in Department of Pharmacology, Faculty of Pharmaceutical Sciences, Government College, University Faisalabad, and also doing PhD in Pharmacology in the supervision of Dr. Malik Hassan Mahmood. So the topic of my presentation is anti-diabetic activity of Barberis brandisiana is possibly mediated through modulation of gamma-in and adipocytokines in high-fat diet and steptozotocin administered rats. Obesity and diabetes are paramount recurrent endocrine metabolic diseases that are characterized by hyperglycemia and impaired insulin action and secretion, that is insulin resistance. So risk factors are genetic predilection, obesity, desmoid lifestyle, consumption of high fat diet, and insulin resistance. Diabetes and obesity is accompanied by various metabolic complications, including dyslipidemia, hyperglycemia, increased level of circulating pro-inflammatory cytokines, and prevalence and complication is that obesity is rapidly growing global pandemic, which has almost tripled since 1975. As of 2016, more than 1.9 billion adults alone having aged more than 18 years were overweight. And of these, over 600 million were classified as obese. So oxidative stress is also associated with overproduction of reactive oxygen species, plays an important role in the development of diabetic complications. Presently available oral hypoglycemic drugs have limitations and hence search for new drugs is defensible. Medicinal plants and their bioactive constituents are commonly used worldwide to control diabetes and its complication due to their non-toxic nature, availability, and affordability. So WHO has recommended the use of traditional plants for the treatment of chronic and life-threatening diseases, including diabetes mellitus. So that's why the aim and objective of my study was chemical characterization of the test material. The name of the plant is Barberis brandisiana, to identify the anti-diabetic activity of Barberis brandisiana on high-fat diet and steptozotocin-induced diabetes, and to evaluate the effect of plant on pro-inflammatory cytokines level. Here is some description about my plant. That plant is a member of Barberiaceae family, and the genus Barberis is a major dicotyledon genus. And the famous vernacular name of the plant is Ishkeen and Shuklu. These are the traditional uses, in which diabetes is also the traditional use of the plant, but is not validated yet. HPLC analysis of my plant shows that presence of various flavonoids and phenolic acids, that quercetin and gallic acid, and phenolic acids are vanillic acid, phenolic acid, benzoic acid, caffeic acid, serinic acid, chlorogenic acid, p-cumeric acid, m-cumeric acid. First of all, the plant is collected and was purchased from Gilgit-Baltistan area of Pakistan. After that, plant extract was prepared by maceration and evaporation by 30-70 ratio of 30 is water or aqueous, and 70% is methanol. So that is aqueous methanolic extract. The final filtrate was air dried, and effective percentage yield was calculated for the crude extract of the plant. So rats weighing 180 to 200 gram of either sex were used in study. Animals fed with a high fat diet for 4 weeks, followed by injection of freshly prepared streptozotocin 40 milligram per kg, that is dissolved in 0.1 molar citrate buffer. Next, a phytochemical analysis was done, and estimation of in vitro antioxidant activity was also done. That phytochemical analysis, total flavonoid content, determination of total phenolic content, high pressure liquid chromatography analysis, and estimation of in vitro antioxidant activity, DPPH radical scavenging assay, hydrogen peroxide scavenging activity, reducing power assay. Here is the experimental design of my a study, that there are 9 groups. One is control, one is diabetic. Diabetic is having the high fat diet, 40% high fat diet for 4 weeks. And after 4 weeks, the one intraperitoneal injection of streptozotocin 40 milligram per kg was given. And after that, if the level of glucose is more than 250, so those animals were considered as a diabetic, and they used for the further study, and they are treated with the plant. Biochemical testing, insulin, diabetic parameters, as well as LFTs, RFTs, lipid profile, inflammatory biomarkers, blood pressure, antioxidant assays, and histopathological studies was done. These are the results and effect of test material on the diabetic parameter. There is a significant decrease in the level of insulin in the diabetic animal. while the significant increase of glucose, glycosylated hemoglobin, and systolic blood pressure in the diabetic animals which are having the high fat diet plus heptazotocin injection, while there is a significant decrease in the level of glucose, glycosylated hemoglobin, systolic blood pressure, and significant increase in insulin in the treated animals which are treated with the plant and the compound. Next is the effect of aqueous methanolic extract of Berberis prednisiana on lipid profile. So there is a significant increase in the total cholesterol, triglycerides, and LDL level, while significant decrease in the HDL level of the diabetic animals. When they are treated with the plant and the compound, there is a significant decrease in the total cholesterol and triglycerides and LDL level, whereas significant increase in the HDL level of the treated animals. And effect of aqueous methanolic extract of my plant on oxidative stress. So there is a significant decrease in the MDA, CAT, and SOD enzyme levels in the diabetic animals. While when they were treated with the plant and the compound, there was significant increase in the level of MDA, CAT, and SOD showing the antioxidative activity. So next is the effect on the LFT, liver function test, and renal function test. So there is a significant increase in the AST, ALT, urea, and creatinine level in the diabetic rats. And when they were treated with the plant and the compound, there was a significant decrease in the level of AST, ALT, urea, and creatinine, showing the effect on the liver as well as the kidney. So there are the results of effect of aqueous methanolic extract of test material on TNF-alpha, IL-6, gamma-ring, adipocytokines in controlled diabetic and treated rats. So as the graph shows that in TNF-alpha, IL-6, leptin, and gamma-ring, there's a significant increase in the level of TNF-alpha, IL-6, leptin, and gamma-ring in the diabetic rats. While when they were treated with the plant and the compound, there is significant decrease in the level of TNF-alpha, IL-6, leptin, and gamma-ring to show its effect on the pro-inflammatory cytokines as well as the, you can say, adipocytokines. When we talk about the adiponectin, there is a significant decrease in the level of adiponectin when there is a diabetes or obesity. And when they were treated with the plant and the compound, there is significant increase in the level of adiponectin in the treated animals, showing the effect on the pro-inflammatory cytokines or adipocytokines. So show its effect on the obesity and diabetes. So these all data, the research also shows that Berberis prednisiana possesses anti-diabetic activity, possibly mediated through positive influence on diabetic parameters, which were glucose level, insulin level, glycosylated hemoglobin, and systolic blood pressure, and also modulation in the gamma-ring, adipocytokines, leptin, and adiponectin, and TNF-alpha, and IL-6, and also on the oxidative stress, that is enzymes, SOD, CAT, and MDA. So thus, this study provides a rationale for the medicinal use of Berberis prednisiana in the diabetes. So this is all about my presentation, and thank you for your kind attention.